Now, if you look directly in front of me, guys, you see those two gateposts? Those are the gates into the Forbidden Forest. Now, that's right up my street because lots of weird and wonderful creatures in there, lots of weird and wonderful mythical creatures and animals, and werewolves. So I should feel right at home in there. So I'm going to grab Hazel and then we'll go in there in a minute.
Hello. Would you like to come into the Forbidden Forest with me?
Yes.
Just this way.
Right, guys, so we're going into the Forbidden Forest now. Ooh, they've got smoke and everything. Werewolves, they've got the lot. It's Hagrid.
Oh, they're Hagrid.
Actually, it's Hagrid. It's a Scottish... Did you know that Hagrid is a Scottish word?
His name is
Hagrid. It's not Hagrid. It's pronounced Hagrid. It's pronounced Hagrid. It might be Hagrid. Either way, it's a Scottish word. Let's have a look. There's Hagrid, Hagrid. She says tomato, I say tomato. Let's call the whole thing off. Let's have a walk through here, guys.
Spooky.
Let's have a look. This is the Forbidden Forest. Or if you're German, Verboten Schwarzwald. That's Forbidden Black Forest. See, I'm even throwing little bits and snippets of different languages in now. Oh, look, it's Buckbeak, or whatever his name is. Oh, what have we got here? Werewolves don't scare me. Well, let's venture further, shall we? Buckbeak. Very timid creatures, these. Avoiding you nowhere to approach them. Yeah, that's my Hagrid voice. Forest fire. What do you mean behind me? My stomach. Sorry. Dark in here, isn't it? Let's head for some light, shall we? That's a Patronus, is it? Favourite animals, spiders! I adore spiders! We used to have a massive collection of spiders. Let's see, they're going to come down now, are they? Come on. I love this. Word, now you're talking. Now you're talking. Oh my word, look at this beauty. This is the actual Hogwarts Express. Just magic. Wow, this is so cool. This is the station. We're going to get back to that Hogwarts Express in a minute. I'm just sold on it. Actually, let's have a little walk along the engine, shall we? Very cool indeed. This is worth the entrance fee alone. In fact, I've paid the entrance fee and more just to see this little beauty. You know what I'm like with trains, and particularly steam. Oh, she's a corker. Look in there, look at, oh wow. Beautiful. Oh my word. Breathtaking. Oh, I'm in love. Don't tell Hazel. Oh wow. Hogwarts Railways. You can go on the carriage. How cool is that? Let's get going. Gonna get on the Hogwarts Express. Sure, that woman who sells chocolate. Hey, you don't think there'd be dementors on here, do you? You know what I'm like with dementors? They frighten me. Bloody dementors. Just going on now, guys. Hazel's all hands are so excited. Look at her little face. She couldn't give up monkeys. Right, so this is the Hogwarts Express. This is the carriages.
The train's
been running. What's a train? It's a train, isn't it? It's not going to be a magical train, is it? It's a train.
Yeah.
All trains are magical, though, in my eyes. Oh, look. It's all frosted up, so there must be a dementor near.
Oh, yeah.
Bloody dementors. Lovely shot at the back of Hazel's head there. Woman, get a buffet cart down here. Ah, that was brilliant. Looking to get into the queue, looking around to it. Do you know what they said about the staff here? Got the staff, they're all friendly. They're a miserable bunch of gits. They've all got faces as long as a motorway. Look, miserable. One of the carriages now. And the lady's taking, bless her, she's taking photos of people. She hasn't got a clue that we're not buying the photos because we've got our own camera here and we can get it on video. Why do we want the photos? We just get some still shots off the camera, but, oh, bless her. Anyway, we're going to video out the window in a minute because I've heard there's dementors coming.
What to do and how to react. All right?
Yes, get on with it, please.
Roll playback and action.
It's like the real British rail. Pay your money, go nowhere. Oh, look at that, we're in Scotland.
You there, look towards the camera, make sure your picture's perfect. Nice job, everyone.
I hope there's no dementors here. I really am frightened of dementors.
Oh, no.
Oh, it's that chocolate bloody frog again. That got away from me earlier. There it is. There it is.
Give it a tap. Try and get it. Try and get it. Oh, no.
Too late. Oh, there's a flying car.
What's that window? Is that Harry and Ron? Quick, give them a wave.
Give them a wave, yeah.
Okay, the carriage is coming to a stop now. It's getting really cold.
Oh, hang on, that's getting cold now.
Start shivering.
I'm trying not to move. Bloody dementors!
Okay, they're going away now. If you're okay, sit up. Look out the window.
Bloody dementor! Bloody dementor! saw him off. I am no longer frightened of Dementors. As a shaking fist, as you could see, generally scares them away. We brought over the butter beers. Let's try these, shall we, and see what we think. Hazel, I'm going to ask you to go first.
I'm
if you
need. Disgusting.
Shall I go first?
Yeah. I'll be the. Taste it. Tell me what it's like. Hazel's first sip of butter beer. Yeah, that really doesn't bode that well, does it? To be honest. Yeah.
Cheers. That's like drinking pure syrup. It's different. It's not something I can regularly drink. Yeah, I don't go bombing it, to be honest. But we pay for it now, so I have to finish it. That's how tight I am. Even if it makes me ill, if I'm going to pay for it, yeah, I'll want it. I definitely wouldn't recommend the butterbeer, guys. It's absolutely disgusting. We tried to sit down and work out what it tasted like, and we come up with the idea or the conclusion that it tastes like a liquid version of candy floss. So if you've got a really, really super sweet tooth, then you'll be all right, but no. See, it's repeating on me now. I drank mine, but I paid for it. Money was exchanged. I'm not wasting it. Another thing that really disappoints me is we're in the backlot cafe here and there's no candles floating above us while we eat. I'm a bit annoyed about that. I tried to write a strong letter to whoever's running this place, to Warner Brothers themselves. I'll finish my lunch and I'll see you in a little bit. We'll carry in front of us.
Is the night bus
pretty cool? Hazel's going to have a look inside and so am I. And we are, and this is Privet Drive. This is the actual set. That's the cottage that was burnt. I think that was in, well, I can't remember, so I'm not going to say. But there's the bridge that goes in, or the covered bridge that goes into Hogwarts itself. And some of the chess pieces right over the back. But let's have a look at the night bus for a minute. See if we can see Hazel. Hello, Hazel.
Hello.
You getting a lift? Excellent. Over the night bus. All destinations, nothing underwater. Can we go on there, Hazel? Hello? Let's get on the night bus.
It's the night bus. Just the night bus. It's the night bus.
There you go. The night bus. Nothing up there. Just a, oh wait, there's no three floors to this.
They're lied.
So you're gonna get down now off the night bus. Oh bloody. And you're gonna, oh, you can go into Privet Drive. Let's have a look. Privet Drive. Shall we have a look in number 4, Hazel?
Yeah.
Let's have a look. Yeah. Private Drive, oh, Privet Drive entrance. Look, shall we? They have very much got our grass. Before. Cool. As you can see, just got upstairs, because it's just a set. That's exactly what it is. Switch over to phone camera now because the battery died on my camera, because this is a blinking long tour. The tour itself can go on for hours. I think we've been here 2.5, almost 3 hours now, and we've only just got halfway through it, so we'll see what else we can do. It's probably too much, so I'll do you some highlights of it anyway. There you go, guys, there's the covered bridge into Hogwarts Court I showed you earlier. Let's walk through, shall we? So remember, guys, this is all the original filming set. These are the real deal. Oh, excuse me, butterbeer repeating. Look through there. It's Privet Drive, that's how close it is. And there is the Potter's Cottage. That's where his mother and father were killed. And I think that's where he got struck by the he who shall not be named Voldemort. There's the a better view of the cottage, of the Harry Potter cottage, or the Potter cottage, where his mother and father met their fate. And again, that close to Privet Drive. So these sets are pretty close together. Some of the effects. So this is Bathilda Bagshot. Very cool. And over here, we have some of the effects for the infrared.
Yes,
and I'm really sorry for a lot of this is spliced, guys, but unfortunately there's so many people here, it's really hard to make it run or flow smoothly. Nearly Headless Nick, as played by John Cleese, superb actor and comedian. So these are the prosthetics and the special effects. Lots of them. Creature shop, I think they call it. Some of the Gringotts staff. Oh, there's forks. There we go. Very cool. Oh, another one. Fenrir Greyback. The Monster Book of Monsters. Very cool. Dobby. There's Dobby there as well. Let's have a look closer look.
Dobby, the house elf. Shall I give him a sock? Let's give him a sock, shall we?
See some special effects tables, or table rather. Werewolf at the end. Hagen's head up there. Various things. Werewolf in a case there. Fenrir Greyback, I think that is. Be Hazel. I don't know if Hazel knows who's behind him. Hazel, there's a werewolf behind you. You're right there. You're, yeah? Bloody wow. Just wow. Now this is phenomenal. Look at the different hats and headdresses that they wore in the movies. Brilliant. Let's have a look around here, shall we? Change hands, excuse me. Okay. Oh wow. Ollivander's there. Part was played by the superb actor, Mr. John Hurt. Sadly passed away. Scribblers. Gringotts, the entrance there. This is super. Not true. So I'm in Diagon Alley. I've got to pick up a few things for Hazel. I've been a bit of a witch and all that. Don't tell her that. Don't tell her that. And just look behind me, how fantastic is that? That set is just superb, isn't it? And as I say, this is really what I wanted to see, and it's met my expectations. It's absolutely phenomenal. Let's take a walk down and see what we can see. Ollivanders, as I said before, Scribblers. Mr. Mole Pepper's Apothecary. Slug and Jiggers. Oh, there you go. Weasley's Wizard Wheezes. Quidditch shop, just magical. Puking pastels. Oh, we should buy those. Dragon's roasted nuts. What a dragon would say about that.
I think I went out with her. You're right there, Hazel.
Yeah, I am.
Is it good?
Yeah, it's good.
Does it meet your expectations? Look at what.
I
know. Our house used to look like that at one point.
Very much, didn't it?
Very much so.
Little tortoises.
I know, they're brilliant, aren't they?
And a spider in a very small box.
Well, yeah. Need to get on the RSPCA about that. Look at this, guys. This is the full scale model that they built prior to building the actual set itself. Because they needed to see it from every perspective. Well, they started off with white card originally, or initially. It's much smaller. This is like a massive. Look at the people down there, give you some idea of scale. It's absolutely humongous and just superb, just fantastic. Hazel and myself were just saying, it makes you want to see the films or watch the films again and read the books. And I must admit, it really does. It's when you see the amount of artwork and the amount of work and effort and skill and talent that's gone into this, it makes you appreciate it a lot more than you did prior to seeing this exhibit. So I suggest you get along here if you get the opportunity and just have a look at it. It's well worth the visit. It's absolutely superb. You won't, I promise you, you won't regret it. Give yourself a ticket now.